The most merciful thing in the world, I think, is the inability of the human mind to correlate all its contents. We live on a placid island of ignorance in the midst of black seas of infinity, and it was not meant that we should voyage far. Humanity has survived for too long. It has survived things that should have destroyed it. This survival hints at a hidden realm of forbidden knowledge, of madness. In the late 1920s, Francis Wayland Thurston inherited the estate of his deceased great-uncle. Among the many documents within the estate was a sealed container, its contents hidden behind multiple locks. Within was a sculpture, an oddity, a pulpy tentacle head, a grotesque body, wings. Alongside that, a document titled with a word not meant to be spoken by human lips, a word which Lovecraft himself pronounced as Kaluhu, but which I will, for ease, refer to as Cthulhu. The document told of the cult of Cthulhu, while other manuscripts detailed strange dreams and explored outbreaks of unexplained mental illness, including vivid visions of Cyclopean titans and indescribable horrors. According to the notes, between February 28th and April 2nd of the mid-1920s, many within New England experienced various versions of the same dream, visions of gigantic, lumbering beasts, which would not leave their memory, driving at least one person to full insanity and eventual death after months of non-stop screaming. Now, these were just non-substantiated notes in an old man's journal. However, also included were newspaper articles detailing cases of panic, mania, and eccentricity across the globe. Francis's great-uncle himself had visions of the being Cthulhu. He was also obsessed with it, an obsession which started years before, when one of his colleagues had discovered a secluded tribe, said by locals to have come down to the earth from the heavens eons before the world was made. The tribe performed human sacrifices in order to appease what they called an elder devil, and they had a statue, not unlike the one found within the box. They also chanted a phrase, which some discovered was being repeated across the globe, without contact by the various speakers. The language, like the beast's name itself, could not be properly said by the human tongue, but roughly translates to, "In his house at Riley, dead Cthulhu waits dreaming." In Louisiana, there was said to be a beast within a hidden lake, which drove people to madness. Nearby, an orgy of hundreds writhed around a great monolith. They said they worshipped the great old ones, incomprehensibly powerful beings who had come from the stars and once ruled Earth. They had given birth to humanity, and while most had died eons ago, great Cthulhu was said to rest in Riley, hence the quote. It was said that one day he would awaken from his slumber, emerge from the ocean, resurrect the old gods, and bring Earth and humanity under their control. Here's a quote directly from the journal. "They worshipped, so they said, the great old ones who lived ages before there were any man, and formed a cult which had never died, hidden in distant wastes and dark places all over the world until the time when the great priest Cthulhu, from his dark house in the mighty city of Riley under the waters, should rise and bring the earth again beneath his great sway. Someday he would call when the stars were ready, and the secret cult would always be waiting to liberate him." These old gods in Cthulhu, however, were not only legend, they actually existed. And they were unending. As explained by the Necronomicon, that is not dead which can eternal lie, and with strange eons, even death may die. Another stone idol was found on a ship left adrift in the middle of the sea, which, according to newspaper articles, had been savagely attacked by people appearing to be cult members. There was only one survivor. However, this was far from the truth. The cult did not set upon a ship. Rather, it had been protecting an area within the ocean, a sort of island, a coastline of mud, ooze, and weepy cyclopean masonry, a great stone pillar sticking out of the sea. It was, in fact, the nightmare city of Raleigh, which pierced the surface but descended forever into the depths. As the boat broke shore, the crew discovered an immense door, which began to open. Cthulhu emerged from the waters, along with an almost intolerable ancient odor, as the men were awed by the cosmic majesty of this dripping Babylon of elder demons. They must have guessed without guidance that Cthulhu was nothing of this or any sane planet. They were witnessing a creature and a city, too great and dreamlike for Earth, with non-Euclidean geometry and dimensions apart from ours. Two sailors died immediately of insanity, while the others fled on their boat, lazily pursued by the beast. Only one was able to escape. The sailors, through unknown means, had accidentally unleashed the great creature, a stumbling mountain of unlimited power. They had done what the cult had failed to, and now Cthulhu was free to roam the oceans and the earth. The above was a brief summary of The Unlocking of Cthulhu from the short story The Call of Cthulhu by H.P. Lovecraft, and represents only a minuscule portion of the Cthulhu mythos, which was created by Lovecraft but has seen contributions from many authors. The mythos deals with the great old ones and other powerful entities as humanity struggles against the cosmic horror of their insignificance. A central theme is humanity's inability to understand the higher powers at play, which causes many who gaze upon the various beasts or entities to just go insane. There are several pantheons of gods, including the Outer Ones, which I would be more than happy to explore in the future. Great Old Ones like Cthulhu are, at least from a human standard, evil. They're usually locked away within some physical or extra-dimensional realm, like Cthulhu was under the sea, yet often attract cults, and maybe wittingly or unwittingly unlocked. Another example of a Great Old One is Gatanathoa, another monstrosity who destroyed those who gazed upon him, or Bokrug, a god of the marsh from the doom that came to Sarnith, or the sea entity Dagon, ruler of the Deep Ones. We can cover any of those and more on the channel. Just let me know if you enjoy this type of content. I put a poll in the upper right hand corner, and in the comments, also make sure to let me know what you'd like to see next. Anyway, until next time guys, this has been Eckhart's Ladder. May the Force be with you.